musical guest, the Tweedies. Brought to you by the Tweedies. Now, here's the Tweedies.
Oh, we should have a theme song for when it's a Basil episode.
Aww.
Since we spend most of our time just looking at Basil.
I thought when we made... Uh-oh, is this pulled up farther enough?
No. Spencer, can you pull the table out a little bit?
I didn't know.
I thought that when we had that introduction made, I asked you if you wanted to add different occasional things, because we could have had the voiceover guy do it.
I don't remember that. Full of baloney. Diane, thank you for our prize
Night
package.
Flight is on there.
We loved it. Yeah.
What's that?
Oh my god, that's the best channel of all time.
Okay, Jeff.
What is it?
It's just all of the stupidest.
I was thanking Diane.
Thank you, Diane.
Thanks, Diane. Oh, you're wearing them? But you can't see what they say if you're...
It says, Butthead of the House.
Butthead of the House.
Nice. Thanks, Diane.
Hi, Danny. Hi, F and Charlesies. Hi, Kendall. Hi, Dad. Hi, Bruce. Hi, Ellen, if you're here. Hi, everyone.
Hi, everyone.
Hi, everyone. You should take your hat off. Thank you. Fluff it. Zhuzh it. Good. Good job. Ooh! Did you just crack your neck?
It might have cracked. I think it was the table, though.
No, it was, came from your head.
It came from my head?
Mm-hmm.
That's just rocks rattling around.
Oh!
You don't hear that much anymore.
You don't hear what?
You've got rocks in your head.
Oh. Why do you wear these in the house?
They make me feel good. What the fuck?
I turned the heat on.
I know, it's boiling.
It feels so good to feel heat.
Oh, that's why it's hot.
It's freezing in here.
I had my door.
Prizes are what we call presents. Yes, please.
See?
See?
Satan, your kingdom must come down. Satan, your kingdom must come down. I heard the voice of Jesus say, Satan, your kingdom must come down. Gonna pray until they tear your kingdom down.
Please.
Pray until they tear your kingdom down. I heard the voice of Jesus say, Satan, your kingdom must come down.
Got it.
There's a misplaced capo.
Capo. You guys, I feel very weak that I turned the heat on today. I know it's only October 1st, but I was freezing my ball sack off.
You can turn it off when we go to bed.
Why would I do that?
Because you're going to be under a comforter. What the fuck do you care?
Yeah, but it's cold out. isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
What's the temperature?
4 below 0. Hi, Appleton. 45. Dave.
Oh, look at 45? Spencer's little hair. He's so cute.
Is it 45 degrees?
Mm. Yeah, mine says 50.
Mine says 48.
I washed it.
You guys are an inch away from each other. Why do you have different temperatures on your phone?
We're using different apps. What weather app do you use?
I'm using the built-in one.
Mm. Well,
Danny, don't start.
What did Danny do?
I don't even want to say it out loud.
What did Danny do?
I don't even want to fucking say it out loud.
Well, I do want to point out that I'm wearing different glasses and no one has noticed.
I mean,
I don't like them as much. They're a little small and make my face look even
no,
rounder.
No, they're not. They actually look bigger than your other ones.
No.
They're thinner.
Your butt's thinner.
That, I can assure you,
but
is
why
not...
did you switch? Were for they... fun? Oh, my God, Jeff. They look exactly the same. You're such a dickwad.
They're not. These are. Look at how much smaller these are. See how small they are?
Do you have supervision right now?
They're the same.
Oh, my God.
Ish.
I can see your
Danny
brain.
Is not older than Susie. I'm older than Danny, and Bruce is older than me. Bruce is the oldest. I'm a middle child, therefore perfect. And Danny's a stupid brat baby.
Do you know why I switched? Because these have loosened up, and they were falling off.
Oh, my God. Mine will not stay on my head. Yeah. They're insanely maybe, stretched out.
Maybe maybe it's because of the cold weather coming in. Our heads are shrinking.
And I'm also, like, really overdue to go to the eye doctor. No, I'm not, Dad. I'm not. Yeah, I am way older than you, Danny. So have some fucking respect. Am I right, Bruce?
Danny. Oh, boy.
I know. Middle child
and
does
these
explain
plus,
why
these
I'm so
these are totally
great.
Different also because they're...
Do you just ignore everything I say and green. Go talking and
they're them. Green and they're filthy now.
Your
I only wore them for like...
Butt's green and filthy.
Well, anyway.
And if you lost 100 million in LA today. It's like 100.
108.
No. Bruce doesn't chime in very much. You're right, Paul. Bruce, say something. Bruce.
You know why?
Bruce is my other brother.
Bruce has class.
No, he doesn't.
No.
How dare you insult him? Bruce, where are you? Say something.
Yeah, he's not going to say anything because he knows he has decorum.
Someone just said, hi, Largo, which means our husband Flanny's here. Hi,
aww.
Flanny.
He said, hi, family.
It was 102 in L.A. today? Jesus Christ.
And Bruce said, I am here.
Oh, he did? I did not see Bruce's comment. See?
He said, hey, Nanny.
He said what?
He said, I am here.
What's Hanani?
It's I am here in Hebrew.
Really? What, are you suddenly fluent in Hebrew?
I think it is, but Bruce didn't say that.
Bruce isn't with Pedro. Bruce facilitates Pedro being able to listen to the show, but Bruce does it from his house, and my dad's at his house. It's very complex, but necessary.
All right. At least you cried upon a pride that's torn to what was we where me meets you where we end to where do I begin so tell when we're in
find within the dream. Where we are to where do I begin? From what was left behind to you, my friends. And I won't ever, ever, ever fall apart like that.
Too.
I never heard it.
You should have at least heard that one. It was free.
It was?
Yeah.
That was so cool. It was very dramatic.
It is. It's dramatic on the
record.
Hi,
Brandy. Brandy's here.
Hi, Brandy.
Hi.
Mmm, popcorn. What's popcorn? Oh, that was probably loud. Sorry, guys. Excuse me for living, Jeff. Dad, Jeff's being mean to me. Oh,
hello.
Hi, Sammy.
Hello, Basil.
Basil's excited.
We should really get like a 70s audience sample thing to like, yeah. Like when Fred Sanford would walk on the set, when Red Fox would walk on the set, like the studio audience. I think yeah. Sammy needs that when he
yes,
enters.
Yes, yes. Someone keeps asking if you eat chopped liver. I'm not sure why they're asking.
They're curious about Judaism, apparently.
You like chopped liver when you're eating meat, right?
Me? Not really. I mean, you have to put like a million raw onions in it for it to be...
Well, that goes without saying. Badoy.
And then I might as well just be eating raw onions. But you know what chopped liver reminds me of is when I was a kid, we ate Braunschweiger.
Oh, I was hoping you wouldn't say that. That word makes me want to vomit.
Braunschweiger?
Ugh. Ew. Mm-mm.
What's we that? Got it from Keister's.
What's Braunschweiger?
It's basically like sort of a pate type of...
Ugh. But it's like beige, right? I don't
it is
like
beige.
Soft beige food.
It is soft beige lunch meat. It would be, you buy it at the deli.
No.
We bought it at the butcher. Keister's.
You know what?
Yeah. You want me to
you
shut up?
You need to stop talking about it. I'm going to vomit.
Yeah.
And I am not a picky eater. There's only one thing. I thought it was one thing, but now it's two things.
You know, it is almost exactly the same thing as chopped liver, so I don't understand what your fucking problem is.
It's beige. It's gross.
So is chopped liver.
Chopped liver's not beige. It's brown.
Oh, that's much better.
It is.
Brown.
Beige foods are rough.
Ew, can we stop talking about chopped liver? It's disgusting.
Thank you, right? Does Jeff like herring and sauerkraut? Who doesn't? You don't like herring? You're the worst Jew ever.
I like sardines.
Sardines are why did A-L-E-X-A pop on when I said you're the worst Jew ever? Oh my god!
Detecting it's hate speech.
Oh my god, that was really weird.
I'm impressed.
Holy shit.
Kudos, Mr. Bezos.
I didn't say anything that sounded like A-L-E-X-A, and she popped on when I said, you're the worst Jew ever.
She's on to us now.
Yeah, she is.
Now she's just listening without letting us know she's listening.
Sardines. I'm so hungry. I'm starving my ball sack off.
You know, we start to gain new followers and new clients, and then you start talking about your ball sack again. And we,
you know what,
run
Jeff?
We run them off.
If you can't handle me talking about my ball sack while you're
watching
Tweedy
show... We've been doing this
show
in the hopes that my career's going to catch on.
If you can't handle me at my ball sack, you can't handle me at my not ball sack.
I get it.
What's not to like about pickled herring? It's delicious, both the vinegary kind and the creamy
kind. Maybe I haven't had any.
Don't start, Danny.
Maybe I haven't had the right stuff.
Herring? I mean, even the Costco herring is delish.
Zaid could tell us all about herring.
Yeah, even though he's deathly allergic to fish.
Yeah.
He used to have to stick his hand... Well,
we,
I think
we heard all about it.
Told that story, right?
Yeah.
But
Jeff doesn't have much fans. Not so much fans.
Not so much.
Canned salmon?
Yeah, that's a good canned salmon.
The wooden robot is out again. It's so creepy.
The what?
The wooden robot.
Oh.
That thing literally scares me.
He says,
hello.
Do you want to talk about our movie night last night?
I'm schwitzing now. No one really wants to talk about that movie except you.
I don't want to... I didn't enjoy it as much as I enjoyed it 20 years ago.
Danny, after sending us your movie list, Jeff refused to watch a movie off of
That's
it.
That's not true.
Oh my God, Danny, are you serious? Danny said, should we test the... I could say it because they can't kick me off, right?
No, let's not
Danny
do
that. No, he tested it with asterisks, not even saying the words, and he got kicked off.
Wow.
Holy shit. Wow. Danny missed it because he was kicked off for hate speech. But Danny,
you
sent your list and Jeff refused to watch something off of
it. No, not at all. Not at all true. I tried to get everybody to watch Bonnie and Clyde, which was on his list.
I would have watched Bonnie and Clyde.
I vetoed it.
Sammy vetoed it.
Sammy, why would you?
Because he said it looked boring.
Oh, Sammy, Jeff, don't make people hate Sammy.
Okay. But then, get this. Somehow, Shoot the Piano Player by Francois Truffaut was not boring looking to these guys. So we watched that.
It's beautiful.
It's not boring, and it is beautiful to look at, but it's just not my cup of tea.
The trailer was not boring looking. The movie was boring.
Because you had to read for...
I wouldn't say it was boring.
Because it was 60s.
Oh, my God. You guys, stop even playing. You're all going to be kicked off. It's, like, insane.
It was a disgusting display of the male gaze in cinema. It was repulsive.
Danny said it's a great movie.
It's got some amazing looking humans in it, that's for sure.
Austin is
Hi, Austin.
Yeah.
I thought it was outrageous. Outrageously sexist and...
Well, Sammy, you can't...
It's outrageously boring.
Everything was sexist then, and it wasn't boring. It just was...
I think it's pretty unpredictable, actually.
The visuals were beautiful, but... I just... It's so up its own ass.
Oh, my God, Sammy.
Truffaut's so up his own ass.
Would you not agree with that? Is that sort of about that movie we watched?
Well,
last
I mean, that's
I'm
kind
not
of
making
the...
any claims about the director.
I don't know. I think if you have to, you know, if you put it in context, he's being completely irreverent and for his time period, I think, you know.
Our
just
husband
like it's
Flanny
like
said,
exciting.
Have you seen the movie Kes? K-E-S? Or was that a typo? Is there a movie Kes? Obviously, we haven't seen it, if there is. Wait, are people agreeing that they don't care for that movie? What's it called again? Shoot the Piano Player?
Yeah. I think George Delarue's score is so fucking beautiful.
Why are
the
we
so... The visuals and the sound made it totally worth watching, even though I disliked
guys,
the movie.
That's
the...
Why are we so cultureless and unclassy that we've never heard of Cats. Everyone's talking about how great it is. It's a British film.
Well, that's probably why.
Jeff doesn't care for the British. Just kidding. Yeah, Bonnie and Clyde is to die for, Sammy. Bedoy. Bedoy. Sammy, come on.
It's you would not have violent video games if it wasn't for that movie.
It's a great movie.
It invented movie violence. Oh,
I can't. That.
I'm just kidding.
Whatever happened to playing Cat Stevens? Did you start a Cat Stevens song?
No.
This is now a movie review show.
It is.
A terrible one.
I'm excited to see Borat. That's my cinema.
Borat? What are you talking about?
The new Borat.
There's a new Borat?
Wait, really?
Yeah.
On October 23rd, the same day as Love is the King.
You're kidding me.
We have to listen to our own album and then watch Borat.
Is it called too. Borat 2?
I don't know.
No, it's called...
Another
It has Mike Michael Pence in the name of the movie.
What?
Yeah. Look up the full title. It's something
Satan,
like...
Satan, your kingdom must come down.
Mm-hmm.
He does something. He goes into somewhere where Mike Pence is speaking.
Oh, my God.
As Donald Trump. Oof. I don't know. There's some trailer where you
it's get... Called, sorry, Nick.
Here's what it's called.
It's called Borat Subsequent Movie Film, Delivery of Prodigious Bribe to American Regime for Make Benefit Once Glorious Nation of Kazakhstan. Also known as... Gift of Pornographic Monkey to Vice Premier Michael Pence.
Spencer, why is your hair so cute?
Because I washed it.
It looks really good.
About washed time. It. Maybe you should do it more than once a year.
I washed it with Trader Joe's tea tree shampoo.
Oh, really?
We've mentioned Costco. This show is really, really sold out.
Is it the tea tree shampoo I bought like decades consumers. Ago?
Yeah, you bought it literally decades. And guess what?
And it didn't turn?
Guess what?
What?
It was the last squirt I used tonight.
Ew.
The last squirt of it.
Don't say squirt.
We've had that shampoo for literally like 10 years.
Oh my God. I bought that so long ago.
Which says a lot about how often we use it.
We have cans of baked beans that we've moved from the three different houses.
No, we don't.
Don't even get me started on the spices.
That was that was not baked beans. It was...
We found spices from the 80s.
No, it was baking powder, baking soda.
We've definitely moved that, but we've also moved the cans of spood from several
of spooge?
Spooge should come in a can.
Ew!
why wouldn't it?
Oh, God, I can't.
I mean, intuitively, you would think tube.
Oh, you guys, you'll be happy to know. You'll be happy to know that the ham is no longer here. It's at the loft. So when it explodes, the Letterman ham, it will explode at the loft.
The Letterman ham incident will be a headline in the future sometime.
It'll ruin three priceless guitars.
Hi, Kathy.
Are you trying to play that one?
Do you want
to
play that
one? Move your fucking feet. Go on, Jeff. Move it. Criminy.
Cricket.
I met a boy called Frank Mills on September 12th, right here in front of the Waverly. But unfortunately, I lost his address. He was last seen with his friend, a drummer he resembles George Harrison of the Beatles. But he wears his hair tied in a small bow at the back. I love him, but it embarrasses me to walk down the street with him. He lives in Brooklyn somewhere and wears his white crash helmet. He has gold chains on his leather jacket, and on the back is written the names Mary and Mom and Hell's Angels. I would gratefully appreciate it if you see him, tell him I'm in the park with my girlfriend, and please tell him Angela and I don't want the $2 back, just him.
Woo! I love that song. Good job, Sammy.
Thanks.
Good job.
Nice job.
Thank you.
Kiddo.
Are you shredding?
No.
Shredding. Is that your shredding face?
Career ender.
I love when hair.
That's what I call
like
that piece.
Campfire.
Well, so what happened was I have one of those neck warmers that has like some sort of bean thing inside. You know, like little beans or rice. And I put it in the microwave for too long today, I guess, and it burnt.
Oh, that's not the smell of a campfire.
No, it smells really bad. And
oh, gross.
I put it on without really thinking about it because I was working, and I had to change my clothes, and it's in my hair, and I'm going to have to wash my hair tonight because it smells. So
campfire, yes. Burnt beans, no.
I had a run-in with a natural fiber item.
What?
Yeah. Last night.
Last night, my buckwheat pillow exploded.
Yeah.
And boy, are there a lot of those little buckwheat flakes in a buckwheat pillow.
Yeah, that is true.
That was quite a mess.
Jeff, do you have a Helen Reddy song? Ready? Helen Reddy? Song ready? People are asking for Helen.
I wish. I don't have one prepared. Mm. You're getting rid of that?
No.
You just want him to
giving
sit here
giving him a seat.
What are you doing?
Yes, hi.
I've been recast.
Spencer's here.
You guys, I got this in
like
the 70s.
I knew I was
70s.
Stiff, but not that stiff.
I think I got this like at an art fair in the 70s.
It's really creepy, Mom.
And I.
When I used to wake up at like 7 a.m. to play video games before anybody else woke up as a little kid. This thing was in that exact spot, staring at me. Okay.
We didn't live
here
then.
Yeah, we did.
When you were
seven.
Oh yeah, we did. He didn't. He wasn't in that exact spot.
Oh, he was.
No, he normally lives in the old school desk chair.
I remember this.
Oh, the old
school desk
chair.
He would get up and walk
to
that chair in
the
morning and then walk back. Mm-hmm.
Sammy, I actually had to get rid of something because you were so scared of it.
It was the ATM.
No, not the ATM. It
well,
was the,
is...
the...
It was the guns.
No, the puppet. The... In the tuxedo. What's his name?
Oh, God. We had a lot of scary
Chucky?
Toys.
No, walk.
I don't remember.
Mortimer Snurd? Charlie McCarthy.
Yes.
Spencer, you want to put this...
What is happening?
I like him.
Spencer, you want to dance with him?
He's been hypnotized.
I like him too. He's sweet.
Oh, people watching at home are probably so creeped out.
I hate that son of a bitch.
Oh, God, Dad.
Sorry.
He's don't
gonna
incur
walk
his
into your room in the middle of the night and stand in the doorway. So you hate me, huh? Oh, I feel bad for him.
So do I. You guys are mean.
When you think about how many things could animate in when we're not in the room in this house.
Wait, is it not called Charlie
terrifying.
McCarthy?
It is.
Charlie.
Isn't it?
Wait, who's that?
What?
What? That's Charlie Weaver.
Charlie Weaver. Ow, Jeff.
You stepped on my foot and yelled at me and said, "Ow."
Yeah, that's creepy.
He's scary.
He's not scary. What is wrong with you people?
All this shit is
and when
scary.
He works, he makes a drink and then smoke comes out of his ears.
What? Really?
Yeah.
Well, the peewee, we've seen, you know, but that's over on the side of the house that needs to get decluttered, perhaps.
Perhaps.
Who gave us that LP case again?
Mark.
Oh, yeah.
Fucking Mark.
Awesome. So cool.
Angela and I.
I need to put my hat back on.
No.
You're making me tired.
Don't. Jeff, I mean, Dad, Jeff just hit me.
What?
He swatted my arm out of the way.
No, I did not.
And actually, it hurt.
No, it didn't.
It did.
I didn't do that.
Oh, you're going to tell me what hurts my body?
I'm sorry.
Oh, yeah, Roseanne Arquette's grandfather.
Charlie Weaver? No, Edgar Bergen? Who? What?
When you apparently, when you don't wear a hat for a whole episode, Paul calls it a no-hatter.
I...
But nobody really knows how many no-pantsers we've done.
That's true.
Spencer had a little... Spencer and I had a little bit of Twitter banter.
What do you mean?
It's our new thing.
Because he tweeted that when he was in preschool, he would come home and immediately take his pants off the second he walked through the door.
That's a true story.
That's what I said. I tweeted... I responded to his tweet with, "Can confirm."
Oh.
Yeah.
Wait, I saw that, but I didn't realize that was you. Slash, not really you, because you don't know how to tweet.
You don't follow me.
I do follow you.
Mm-hmm. No, you don't. Is Basil sleeping?
Yeah, let's go to the hot dog.
His eyes are open.
He's contemplating.
Basil! Hi!
Basil wants everyone to know tonight's the harvest moon. Tonight's a harvest moon? Tonight is the harvest moon.
Oh, we should play
what
harvest
the crunk?
Moon.
We should go outside and look at it.
There's a full moon twice this month.
We've played it a billion times.
Yeah. Wow. What do you mean you don't know how to play it?
No, I said I think I know how to play it.
Haven't you already done it?
They have done it.
What?
They have done it.
They? Or we? Did you say they?
We did.
Yeah. Okay, what's... No. Are you going to go over there?
Yeah, I was like waiting for the
Oh my god, Casey, you just scared the shit out of me.
Oh god. Can we just
why don't you all sing it together? Good job, guys.
Sorry. Sorry. Sorry, Mr. Young. I apologize.
Wait, Danny, I saw you say something during the song that someone said mute Danny. Do you have a hater? Danny, what happened? Someone tell me. Oh, I want to know who Danny's hater is.
Oh, hey!
I love you.
Is it true, guys? Did someone say mute Danny? Yes, Basil is so cute. Mm. Yes, Spencer.
And that's how you learn funk.
I'm sad.
Because of my slap bass playing?
No, because I remembered that Peggy died.
I'm sorry.
Did she?
Yes, she did.
Forgetting it. I can't keep it in my head, and then every time I remember, I get sad again.
Yes, she did.
She did.
Aww.
Rest in peace.
You wish you had a hater? I'll hate you, person. Joe Pina. Alright, it went by too fast. What?
That's so sweet of you.
Isn't it? Guys, song.
Such Great Heights by the Postal Service.
Nice.
Get in close to that slapping.
Get down with your funky bad self, Jeff.
I was always so good at that.
Kind of forte.
It's kind of. Yeah, what I'm known for, really.
Slap of the bass.
Like a
bet nobody had bass slapping on their bingo card.
Everybody should sing along.
Everybody should sing along.
With everything.
I agree.
That slap shook something loose in me.
Ooh, oh, yeah.
It's crazy.
Talking about Paul Rudd.
Slap at the bass.
Oh, and
he
also
says slap at the bass in one of their movies.
Allegedly Trump's in quarantine.
It's not alleged, it's true.
Yeah, but he can get an immediate test, so what's
the deal?
No, but
that doesn't matter. You don't, it doesn't.
Ooh, wasn't he supposed to go to Wisconsin?
It wouldn't show up right away.
Can he quarantine forever?
Yes,
that would be wonderful.
Quarantine forever. The new rule is you have to quarantine forever.
The CDC guidelines have been changed.
Mr. Trump.
But wasn't he supposed to go right now, like, to Wisconsin and kill everyone there?
I think
there?
It was this weekend.
But Wisconsin's in bad shape, and he should not be going there and having a thing with no mask.
You're just preaching to the choir.
Yeah,
he
I know.
Shouldn't be going.
Why are we even talking about him?
You brought him up.
Well, everyone's talking about the news just came out that he's quarantined.
That, I mean,
Yes, he is a virus.
I was wondering why there was an extra, like, kind of, like, lift in the environment.
Sam, oh, so good.
In his bunker?
It's fishy that he said that he's waiting for test results. Yeah. Because wouldn't he get it right away? That's what Austin just said.
Yeah. I think they will lie about it if he has it, for sure.
Yeah, we won't know for some time.
The deeper under...
We did, like, a little witch spell.
What do you think about it, Basil?
Basil's stance is far too radical.
But what's he worried about? I thought he took hydroxychloroquine.
Yeah, take some. Take a lot.
Susie.
What?
This is really unbecoming of a lady.
Okay, Truffaut.
Is that line from the movie?
Who are you calling a lady?
Sammy has a friend. Since we're in politics hour now, I wanted to share that Sammy has a friend who whose identity we may reveal, but a friend who now, as of Governor Abbott of Texas's recent executive order, if it is an executive order, has to drive 2 hours to drop his ballot off for this election because of the...
What?
It was a proclamation, wasn't it?
What what do you mean? Why?
They shut down all of the satellite election boxes.
That is outrageous.
Ballot boxes.
They made it one ballot box per county, and there are fucking ginormous... It's Texas.
There are counties in Texas that are 1,700 square miles.
And he's lying and saying that it's because of security.
Elections.
As if they've ever had a problem counting paper ballots.
They're also the Texas state legislature is also trying to make it so young people can't vote by mail. And they're also trying to make it so...
Yeah. Hey, I want to go on the record.
So that you don't automatically get a vote by mail ballot.
I want to go on the record that that's primarily the Republican Party doing those things. And I would like to say that if the Democratic Party ever did anything like that, I would absolutely speak out against it because it's fucking anti-American and it's wrong.
How can they do that?
You know, so I think that if there are any Republicans of any conscience left at all, they should be outraged. It's not how it works.
That
you're supposed to fucking vote.
Absolutely.
It's like we're all
insane.
Supposed to vote.
Hank Hill would be outraged, a Texan.
Yeah.
it's like denying other people their you know, equal representation is like the name of the game these days, and that makes me want to fucking puke. Anyway, this is the most political the show's ever gotten.
Who has...
It needs to happen.
It's like we don't have the energy to hold it in anymore.
Right. Well, it's
well, it's not as if we've been trying to make it not, like,
No, it's not like... It's just a respite in a lot of ways.
Yeah,
But this is...
there is no respite anymore.
We have one major party in our country that's holding an election and another party that's running against an election. And that is fucking scary and wrong.
Yeah.
And they should lose badly for that strategy to run it, not just against a candidate and fair and square, but run against the whole notion of democracy. Fuck you.
Oh my God.
Sorry.
This is them.
I don't think that I've said anything that could be construed as controversial, personally.
Yeah. Not to us.
It's patriotic.
Ugh. I cannot anymore.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Ooh. I mean...
What bottle rocket song?
Wave that flag.
Wave that flag, Hoss. Wave it high. Do you know what it means? Do you know why? Mm-hmm. Maybe being a rebel ain't no big deal, but if somebody owned your ass, how would you feel?
Why are you holding your hand like Bob Hope? I mean, Jack Benny.
Jack Benny. Well.
Oh, they.
I'm wearing my Riding with Biden shirt that they sent me. That Susie didn't, she's like, what is it?
which made me think that it's maybe not the best design.
You were showing it to me from far away, and I couldn't see the light-colored E.
Couldn't?
Let's see it.
Couldn't?
I couldn't. Are you making fun of the way I speak?
The way you say couldn't.
I couldn't.
You said couldn't.
I couldn't. I can't hear you. I have an ear infection.
Here, let me finger it out.
Yeah, that's what we would say. I'll finger it out. That's disgusting. We were like eight.
You had to be older.
I
can't hear you.
I have an ear infection. I'll finger it out.
Somebody said now their 11-year-old is asking what spooge is.
You're welcome.
Oh, I think. Wait, is
an 11-year-old would know.
Yeah.
Ew.
Here's a demonstration.
Oh, God. What is happening here?
I don't know.
What is
when
going
a man,
on?
When a man and a woman love each other.
That looks dangerous. Be careful, Spencer. I love that song.
They rub each other's butts together.
Touch butts.
They touch their butts.
Guys, it's 9:59 for F's sake.
Oh, it is?
You don't even have a guitar. It's 9:59.
If I was a bird and you was a fish, what would we do? Well, I guess we'd wish for
rain.
Incarnation rain. Oops, wrong key. If I was a bird and you was a fish, what would we do? Well, I guess we'd wish for rain. I guess we wait for the power of reincarnation. Reincarnation. Would it be a sensation to come back to like in reincarnation?
Bye, everybody. Bye, you guys. See you
Bye.
Soon.
Hang in there, everybody.
Yeah, do that.
Hang in there.
Hang in there.